About 8 years ago, I was diagnosed with something called spinal disc herniation. Herniated disc, or known as slip disc, occurs when one of the discs, which sits between the bones, slips out of its allowed space and starts pressing the nerves. This brought me to quite severe pains on my back and legs and made me almost impossible to walk. Doctor said, "Let's cut it out." I said, "Sure. Do whatever necessary so I can walk normally again." But things got worse. When I stood up after 2 weeks from surgery, I couldn't feel my left leg touching the ground. That's quite a weird feeling, actually. So I had to pass through several months of exhausting rehabilitation process, during which several MRI images of my spine were taken and shown to many doctors. But the fascinating thing was, given the same medical images and same medical history, I got three different diagnoses and three different treatment plans from three different doctors. So, as I really wanted to walk normally again, this brought me to a new hobby: to learn about similar medical conditions and try to investigate my images myself. Maybe I could figure out which treatment plan could work for me best. But mostly, it made me start wondering, what if there is a doctor who could remember large data sets of patients' information, including their medical history, medical images, treatment plans, a doctor who could read and digest all the recent thousands of research articles on a topic, a doctor who could remember all the 10,000 diseases humans can get with their symptoms, and finally, a doctor with ice-cold objectivity and no cognitive bias. At the time, living in my hometown, Yerevan, in Armenia, I couldn't imagine that this concept of super doctor is actually possible. But turns out that the concept of super doctor is quite realistic, not with flesh and bones, but rather with combinations of ones and zeros. Just imagine having a huge database of medical data from different imaging modalities, collected from a broad range of patients with their medical images, medical history, and treatment plans in one place. This tremendous opportunity of data influx have never been available before. Based on this data, smart algorithms could do an objective analysis that doctors today largely cannot. Once we have large enough data set and database of research articles, these smart algorithms could allow to identify patterns and physiological interactions that have never been possible before. And what this means is that we will need fewer doctors, and the patients will get the best care, while the diagnosis and treatment plan will be done by Dr. Algorithm. I like him a lot, so I'll simply call him Algo, Dr. Algo. So what this also means is that the job of certain doctors, to be more specific, radiologists and physicians, will be at higher risk of being automated and maybe partially replaced by Dr. Algo. And this is just one example of a job which requires several years of education and training is at high risk of being automated. In fact, scholars in Oxford University have studied around 700 US occupations and new techniques of automation, and they concluded that 47% of the existing jobs are at high risk of being automated for the next 1-2 decades. And as another example, the job of lawyers, certain lawyers, can be at higher risk. Algo can determine which documents are needed for certain court cases. Or jobs in financial industry, such as accountants, when Algo can analyze financial data, prepare accounts, do tax returns, or jobs in human resources when algo can sort through resumes and find the best candidates. And this list can be continued further. But you may say, look, this concept of new technology destroying jobs is not new. Back in 1800s, the mechanization of agriculture evaporized millions of jobs and led workers move from farms to factories. Later, manufacturing automation caused the transition to the service economy. And what basically happened was workers repeatedly adapted by acquiring new skills and moving to the new job industries. But this did not change the fact that most jobs today continue to be essentially routine. And how workers responded was moving from a routine job in one industry to the routine job to another. But what's different today is that information technology is transforming almost every sector of the economy. For the first time in history, algo is taking on jobs which once were patented by human brain. Even jobs which maybe seem exclusive for human brain, with tasks such as mobility and hand-eye coordination, algo promises to impact them too. In this respect, the job of taxi drivers and truck drivers is at higher risk. Self-driving cars and trucks have already been tested for hundreds of thousands of kilometers, driving without accidents in regular streets. In one study, around 2,000 experts were asked whether algo will have displaced more jobs than it creates by 2025. And half of the experts, almost half of the experts, see a future in which algo have displaced more jobs than it creates, and many are concerned that this will lead to vast increases in income inequality, massive unemployment, and breakdown of the social order. However, the other half of the experts, and me personally, see future as more positive for new job creation. Although we believe that algo will displace several jobs, but it will generate new categories of jobs, giving rise to, as people in science like to say, second and third order effects, which leads to more human-robot collaboration. We have faith that our creativity, human creativity, will generate new jobs and industries by taking advantage of our unique human capabilities. Now more than ever, we need an army of talented coders to help our technology advance. Somebody has to code and build these tools, which will likely lead to these new waves of innovations and jobs. In fact, LinkedIn, the world's largest professional network, examined around 260 million profiles in its database and created an infographic of most popular jobs that did not exist back in 2008. And they found out that 8 out of 10 of these jobs belong to the digital world. And examples include app developer, data scientist, intern in social media, and many others. If we had gone back 15 years from now, who would have thought that search engine optimization is a significant job category? This already shows the newly formed lifestyle trends. And besides, there are several jobs only humans can do. Many jobs requiring unique human capabilities, such as empathy, creativity, judgment, negotiation skills. Jobs of this nature are unlikely to be replaced by algo. And coming back to doctors, they will have more time talking to their patients and providing more compassionate and personal care. And ultimately, they will be able to handle more patients and reduce the medical costs. I wish I had Dr. Algo at my side when I really, really needed him. So maybe algo will free us from our hardworking day-to-day routine and allow us to define our relationship with work in a more positive and socially beneficial way. But the big question remains, Will our economic and social structures adjust fast enough to this new reality? Will our education system be transformed fast enough in preparing graduates for a more automated world? One thing is more certain, though, that this transition is likely to be disruptive. And I'm very excited that I get to live through it. I hope you too. Thank you.